Hello students, welcome to online class. So today we are going to study subject that is social science. Social science, okay? So subject social science. In social science, we are going to deal the branch that is history, chapter number 1, advent of Europeans to India, class 10th, part 4. Okay, children. So this is the fourth part of the video, the lesson that is related to advent of Europeans to India. So before discussing about the second climatic war and third climatic war, so let us have a glance what I have discussed in the previous class. Okay, children. So in the previous class, I discussed about the first climatic war. The first climatic war, it has been fought in the year 1746 and it has been ended in the year 1748. Okay, children. So here you can see that, children, Lord Vardenis. So Lord Vardenis, he was the military leader of Mauritius. So he came to India when Dupleix followed him. So he came to India and he captured Madras. So Madras, this was the presidency of English. Okay, children. So here only the war has been started. Okay, so when the presidency was captured by the French, then the English, they asked the help of Anwaruddin. So here Anwaruddin, he was the Nawab of the Carnatic region, children. So he sent his army to defeat Lord Vardenis. Okay, but children, Anwaruddin's army, this army has to face the defeat. Okay, children. So when here the army of the Anwaruddin and the English, they face the defeat, they have to come back. And then, children, here a clash has been taken place between Dupleix, the French governor Dupleix, and Lord Vardenis. Okay, and this situation has been exploited in the favor of the English. And what they did, the English gave money to Lord Vardenis. So in return, Lord Vardenis, he returned back Madras. It was the presidency of the British people. Okay, so like this, the first war of Carnatic, this has been ended. Okay, so it has been ended with the treaty that is called as the Treaty of Aix-la-Chapelle. So this was signed between the France and the English. Okay, so this point I have discussed in the previous class. So today's class I am going to discuss about the second Carnatic war. So before discussing the second Carnatic war here, children, you must and should have to know the background, the circumstances, what has been taken place. Well, children, here the Nizam of Hyderabad, his name is Asaf Jah, he died in 1748. A battle has been taken place. Who is going to become a Nawab? Okay, so the battle has been taken place between the Nasir Jung. Nasir Jung, he was the son of who? Asaf Jah. Okay, between Nasir Jung and his daughter's son Muzaffar Jung. Okay, these both were having the clashes. Who is going to become the Nizam of Hyderabad? Okay, children. So here, in the other hand, war has been taken place between the Chand Sahib. Chand Sahib, he was the prisoner of the Maratha. So he was released. A war has been taken place between Chand Sahib and Anwaruddin in the Carnatic region. So you know that, children, Carnatic region, it is the eastern part of Tamil Nadu. Okay, so here in Hyderabad, a clash has been taken place between Nasir Jung and Muzaffar Jung. Then in Carnatic region, a war has been taken place between Chand Sahib and Muzaffar Jung. Hyderabad, here Nasir Jung and Muzaffar Jung. Okay, so then in Carnatic region, Chand Sahib, Group A, Group B. Okay. So here you can see that the French extended their support to Muzaffar Jung in Hyderabad and they extended their support to Chand Sahib in Carnatic region. So in A group here, French, Chand Sahib. the Nizam of Hyderabad. Salabhadra he became the Nizam of Hyderabad. So French here, the French, what they did, they appointed an officer. His name was Bussi for the protection of the Salabhadra. Okay, children. So here in this situation, when Chand Sahib, he was in Nawab of Karnatak. So he died. He died. After that, here you can see that children, Robert Clive, he attacked the capital city of Carnatic region. Its name is Arcot. Robert Clive attacked the important capital city that is called as Arcot. Then finally, children, here in the place of Chand Sahib, the English named Muhammad Ali, he was the son of Anwaruddin, who was in the favor of the Britishers. Here he became the Nawab of Karnatak. Okay, so like this here, children, the second Carnatic war also has been ended with the Treaty of Pondicherry. So in this war, the French has to face the defeat, and once again the English is going to be won. In the second Carnatic war, Treaty of Pondicherry has been signed. Treaty of Pondicherry. Okay, Treaty of Pondicherry has been signed. Okay, children. So here the second war, it brought Lawrence to the English, and the French has to face the defeat. Okay, children. So once again, I am going to repeat my all the points here, children. So here you saw that Salabhadra Jung became the Nizam of Hyderabad. Then for his protection, an officer has been named. His name was Bussi. Okay, an officer has been appointed for his protection. His name was Bussi. Later on, after the death of Chand Sahib here, children, here you can understand it as here the Robert Clive, he was really very clever. Later on, you will understand what kind of personality he was. Okay, so here with his cunning policies, what he did, he attacked the capital city of Carnatic region. It is Arcot. Okay, so here after capturing the Arcot, so here what they did, in the place of Chand Sahib, Muhammad Ali, he became the Nawab of the Carnatic region. Okay, children. So like this, the Treaty of Pondicherry that was signed between the French and the English. So like this, in the Carnatic region, here the English, they won the battle. Okay, so we will move to the third Carnatic war. So the third Carnatic war, it has been started from 1756 to 60. Okay, children. So children, here Count de Lally. So here Count de Lally, he was the commander of the French army. So what he did, he captured Vodibosh. He captured Vodibosh. Reasons for the third Carnatic war. Count de Lally captured Vodibosh. Captured Vodibosh in this year, children, in 1760. In 1760. Sorry, 60. So, in 1760, Count de Lally, when he captured Vodibosh, so here this situation enraged the English. So they sent Sir Eyrecourt. So he was also a military general from the English army. Sir Eyrecourt. was a military general. Next video. Okay, until that, children, take care of yourself. Thank you for watching.